more than 200 centimeters. Second has a tropical deciduous forest. Third, mangroves. Fourth has a thorny shrubs. Now as a turn for the montane vegetation. Montane vegetation. Fifth category of a natural vegetation, mountainous vegetation. Mountainous vegetation. Himalayas are an area of a variety of a natural vegetation. Such variation in a vegetation is generally occur due to the altitude. As we learned in previous chapter, when we moving towards the upward in altitudinal areas, mountainous regions, temperature falls. It's due to the normal lapse rate. That fall of a temperature occur as after every 165 meters, 1 degree Celsius temperature decreases. That's why the plains are experiencing as a extreme weather conditions or somewhere as the moderate also, but in a mountainous regions as a cold weather conditions are prevailing throughout the year. So Himalayas, which are known for the variety of a plants, species, the climatic conditions here change with the altitude and the direction of slopes in relation to the insolation. The southern slopes of a Himalayas facing towards India, they are having as a dense growth of vegetation comparatively the northern slopes of Himalayas, part of China having as a scattered growth of a vegetation as compared to the southern slopes of Himalayas. Till the height of 1,000 meters from mean sea level, as a tropical deciduous forests are growing in such areas, especially in a dry weather conditions. Those regions which are receiving as an annual rainfall till 120 centimeters or less than 120 centimeters or it's less than, they are known for the location of a tropical deciduous forest. But in such areas where as a more rain occur, means as a foothills of mountains, Piedmont areas of a mountains or terrain lands of a alluvial plains, these regions are known for the tropical evergreen forest. Tropical evergreen forest or rainforest. Above the height of 1,000 meters towards the 3,000 meters, such kind of the vegetation is known as the coniferous vegetation. 1,000 towards the 3,000 meters from a mean sea level, coniferous vegetation growing in those areas which are lies as a 1,000 towards the 3,000 meters from mean sea level, which includes as a silver fir, cedar, deodar, pine, etc. Such species of trees are growing in a coniferous vegetation. Afterwards, we discussed regarding as a above of a 3,000 meters to 3,500. 3,000 meters towards the 3,500 as the growth of alpine vegetation. In alpine vegetation, the important species of trees growing in this region are as the silver fir, spruce, S-P-R-U-C-E, spruce, silver fir, sal, etc. And above the height of 3,500 towards the 5,000 meters. 3,500 towards the 5,000 meters as the growth of shrubs. Shrubs, grasses are growing in above the height of 3,500 towards the 5,000 meters. Above of the 3,500 is not possible for a growth of vegetation. All these things we discussed in a previous class. So let's we continue towards as a wildlife now. Wildlife. This much we done in a previous class. Those who joined us lately. Now we will start from the for the next chapter, next part of a chapter, wildlife resource. Same as the natural vegetation, India is also rich in a wildlife species. Same as the natural vegetation in our country, as a wildlife species are also present. Ashwin, we just started the chapter. Earlier, I just as recalled all those things which we discussed in a previous week. Yes, Ashmit. Now let's start for the wildlife. Ashmit.
Sir, thorny shrubs ki adaptive conditions bataoge?
Thorny shrubs which are adapted there ground water, deeper roots reaching towards as the underground water to complete their water necessity, because thorny shrubs are growing in regions receiving as a low rainfall. Second, as they are having as a waxy stems, W-A-X-Y, waxy stems to reduce the process of evapotranspiration. Waxy stems. Third, as a leaves are generally as a smaller in size, or either the leaves transform into the spines, S-P-I-N-E-S, spines, to protect them from the animals. So for which as a vegetation adapted their harsh weather conditions. The important species are the kicker, date palm, baboon, cactus are growing in such regions. So let's start for the wildlife now. Clear, Ashmit? Ashmit, still any query? Okay, let's proceed towards as a wildlife. As such, the natural vegetation in our country as wildlife species are also growing in a larger in number. India has a having as a great diversity of the relief climate and the wildlife species. There are about the 89,000 species of a fauna present in our country. 89,000 species of fauna, 2,500 species of a freshwater, 2,500 species of freshwater fishes, 12%, which has constitutes the 12% of a total world's fish stock. I'm again repeating, as 89,000 species of a fauna present in our country. Fauna denotes as a animal species, 2,500 species of a freshwater fishes present in our country, which has constitutes the 12% of a total world's fish stock all over the world. 9,000 species of birds are there, out of which the 1,200 present in our country. 1,200 species of birds present in our country. 1,200 species of birds present in our country, which has constitutes the 13% of a total world stock of birds. 13% of total world's stock of a bird species, 13% is present in our country. 5 to 8% of the world's amphibians, reptiles, mammals are present in our country. Mammals, reptiles, amphibians present in our country. Insects, worms, amphibians, reptiles, mammals, they are present in our country, which has constitutes the 5 to 8% of a total world's present. As the animals which prefer as hot and wet climatic conditions, they are generally present in a northeastern states of Assam. Northeastern states of Assam, Sundarbans, Western Coastal Plains, these regions are the rich in a fauna. These regions are rich in animal species, which are mainly found in a hot and wet climatic conditions. Wild asses dominate the arid areas of a run of Kutch. One horned rhinoceros, rhinos, they are fall in a category of mammals, which are generally found in regions of Assam, Meghalaya, and West Bengal. One horned rhinoceros. In Assam, they are found in a Manas and Kaziranga. In Manas, M-A-N-A-S and Kaziranga. One horned rhinos, which categorized under the mammals, lies in a Manas and a Kaziranga of Assam. They live in a swampy and a marshy lands of Assam and West Bengal. The other animals put in the category of mammals include the Indian bison, Indian buffalo, Nilgai, Chausinga. Chausinga is one of the species of deers. Chausinga means as a four-horned antelope, black buck, which is found in a Sariska in Rajasthan, with relation to the black buck. There was as a controversy raised when Salman Khan killed the black buck, gazelle, deer, and there are several varieties of a deer, of which Kashmir stag, swamp deer, spotted deer, musk deer, and mouse deer are present in our country. Clear? Mouse deer are present in our country. Generally, as a wildlife species, one horned rhinoceros present in a Manas and Kaziranga of Assam. M-A-N-A-S, Manas and Kaziranga of Assam. So now next, as a species, categories, classification of a wildlife species. Wildlife species of animals are categorized into the five categories. First, as a normal species. Normal species. Those species of animals which are present everywhere, which are generally found present in our environmental conditions, in our surroundings. Such species of animals, they are present in our surroundings as normal species. Cows, buffaloes, dog, cat. These are the normal species which are present in our surroundings. These are present in everywhere. Normal species of animals. Clear? Second, as a vulnerable species. Vulnerable species of animals. Vulnerable species of animals. Those species of animals, vulnerable are the, those species of animals, those species of animals, which were earlier in normal, but due to the human factors in relation to the poaching, hunting, loss of habitats, due to the human factors, their population decreasing day by day. If such species of animals, they will not protect at present, then they will categorize under the endangered. Those species of animals, which were earlier, lies in a normal, but due to the human factors, their population decreasing day by day. If they will not protect at present, then they will categorize under endangered. They will categorize under endangered, like Barasingha. Earlier their population, it was as a larger due to as a loss of the habitats, loss of the forest lands, their population has affected. Second, as elephants, elephants, vulnerable species, Barasinga. It is as a species of antelopes, Barasinga, Barahsingha. Barasinga. Elephants lies under a vulnerable species. Till there, any questions? Normal, those species which are present in everywhere. Vulnerable, those species of animals which earlier as a lies in a normal, but due to as a decreasing their surface area, due to as a hunting, poaching, now they are, their population has affected, highly affected. In near in future, after 10, 15, 20, 50, 25 years, they will categorize under the endangered category. Clear? Now the third, endangered species of animals. Endangered species of animals. Endangered species of animals. Endangered species of animals. Those species of animals which are reaching at a level of extinction means due to as a human factors, their population has drastically decreased. If they will not protect at present, then they may extinct. They may vanish from environment. They will finish from the environment. They will vanish from environment. These categories of animals are endangered. Example, black buck. Why do as a black buck controversy it raise? Because it is as a endangered category and a violation of a law. It is as the violation of law. Black buck present in Sariska. Black buck, B-U-C-K, present in Sariska, Rajasthan. Sorry. Sariska in Rajasthan. Royal Bengal tiger of Sundarbans. Tigers, very good, Eva. Tigers in Sundarbans. In endangered. Ramneek, one horned rhinos are also categorized under the endangered, which has present in a Manas and Kaziranga. Manas and Kaziranga. These three are the endangered species. Asiatic lions now presently is not as a endangered, but their habitats are the delimiting. It may be as a categorized under the vulnerable species. Tigers, rhinos, and black buck, their population has a highly affected. As per the one estimate, according to the British records, in 1901, the beginning of the 20th century, in 1901, total number of tigers were present in our country near about 120,000. 120,000. 120,000 number of a. Yes, Ramik, it can be as a categorized under endangered pandas, but they require as a particular weather conditions only, Himalayan region. We will categorize under the some other category. Okay. In 1901, there were a total number of 120,000 total number of tigers were present. Till independence, that number of such tigers, it was as a decrease till as a 40,000. 40,000 remaining till as a independence. It's due to as the smuggling of their body parts. Skin of a tigers demanded in a world market at a high rates for which as a tigers they killed by, during as a British age. Hunting, it was as a legalized during the British age. But afterwards, till 1987, 1947 towards 1987. 40 years, the total number of 1,200 tigers remaining in our country. 1,200 tigers remaining in our country. So if they will not protect at present, they may extinct from environment. So they categorize under the endangered, protected species. These are the protected species. Clear? Till there, any questions? If anybody having any, ask any of the remaining portion, they can ask now. If anybody having any question, they can ask. Otherwise, we will continue towards the next species, are the endemic. Endemic species of animals. E-N-D-E-M-I-C. Endemic species of animals. Endemic species of animals. So panda, it will categorize under this. Those species of animals which are growing in a particular weather conditions. Particular weather conditions are known as the endemic. Those species of animals which can only survive in a particular geographical and climatic conditions are known as the endemic. They are known as the endemic. They are known as the endemic. Himalayan panda. Himalayan panda. Himalayan panda. Yes, camels also, which can be also growing in a desert conditions. Polar bear, we can't as categorize under this because it is not present in our country. All such, it can be as a use under the endemic species as polar bear, penguins, but in India, these are not present. Here we are talking about a such number of a species of animals which are present in our country. Those animals which are present in our country. Clear? Those animals which are present in our country. So cold weather conditions are desirable for a growth of a Himalayan panda. Cold weather conditions. They can't exist in a other type of a weather conditions. So endemic are the those species of animals which can only survive in a particular weather conditions or geographical conditions. Geographical conditions. At the upper Himalayan region, whereas cold weather has prevails throughout the year, favorable for a growth of a panda. Favorable for growth of panda. That's why you are not seeing the panda in any of a zoo. Zoo which has located at the plain surfaces areas. They are only surviving in parts of a higher altitudinal parts of Himalayas where extremely cold weather conditions prevail throughout the year. Yes, very good. Achita given as an example of a yak. It is as another example. Afterwards, as the panda, yak. Y-A-K categorized under the endemic. Because they are present in a cold weather conditions. Yak. Good job given the example of a camels. Clear? Endemic clear. Next are the extinct species. Extinct species. Extinct species of animals. Those species. Extinct species. Those species of animals which are vanished, which are finished from the environment. Totally finished. Extinct from environment. Finished from environment. Due to as the human factors, their population decreased and they were not protected. At present, they are not existed in environment. Very good. Dodo. They are good example. Dodo. In context of India, as a dodo as a best example. D-O-D-O, regarding as the dinosaurs. Gangetic dolphins, they are in an endangered. They are still as a present. Gangetic dolphins are still present, level of extinction. Do hai, come hai, come hai. If they will not protect, they will finish from the environment, are endangered. Which are not present in the environment are extinct. which are extinct. These are extinct, which are not present in environment are extinct, whose population has a decreasing and reaching at a level of extinction, but still as present. These are endangered. Clear, Archana? Any other? Clear? Species of animals, normal species found everywhere in all our normal conditions, cows, buffaloes. Those number of species of animals present in a, those species of animals earlier as a present in a normal, but due to as a human factors, their population decreasing, named as a vulnerable species like elephant. Third are endangered. Those species of animals, which are reaching at a level of extinction, still as a present, but still are present, are endangered. They are protected for improving their existence in a country. Endemic, which are lies in a particular weather conditions, in a geographical climatic conditions where they can as a survive, are the endemic species, and afterwards as an extinct species. Those species of animals which are totally finished from environment, which are no more to see in our surroundings, are known as the extinct species. So these are the major categories of a species of animals. Next, as the what reasons are responsible for a what why are the birds and animals are endangered? What reasons are responsible for the animals becomes as endangered? First, as a loss of habitat. For loss of habitat for agriculture, expansion of cities, urbanization, industries, construction of dams leads to the loss of habitats for animals. First reason responsible for the why do the most number of animals are endangered? Animals are endangered. Most number of animals are endangered because first reason, loss of habitats as in a present, due to as a commercialization of agriculture, more land required for cultivation, for production of a cash crops like as a tea, rubber, for which as a deforestation occur in larger in scale, which leads to the destruction of habitats. Commercialization of agriculture, urbanization, expansion of cities. Presently as the cities are occupying the agriculture land, so that agriculture land shifted towards as a forest land. That's why as animals lost their habitats. Construction of dams, which leads to deforestation in a larger in scale. Industrialization for industries, for furniture, paper, we require a wood for which as a trees are cutting in a larger in number. Deforestation occur in larger in number. So first reason responsible for the animals becomes as endangered as a loss of habitats. Second, human predation, hunting and poaching responsible for poaching means as a illegal smuggling of the body parts. Illegal smuggling of body parts. As per the now present, if anybody kept the animal parts at their homes, this is as an illegal activity. It may be as a convicted against as law. If anybody having as the horns, skins, teeth of animals, it is as the illegal activity. Either the person has not hunted the animal, but it will be as a convicted against of a law. Case will file against of that individual which will kept as a materials. Tusk of elephants, skin of tigers, horns of rhinos, feathers of birds, skull of deer and other animals. If any one of such materials kept by the any of an individual at their homes, this is as the against of law. Because when we are demanding, then the supply present in a market. If you will not as a demand, when we will not as a demand, then supply will not occur. Animals will not hunt. Animals are basically as a hunt because of their high demand. Their body parts are demanded in a world market. Hunting has been another major cause of extinction. The animals and birds are killed for their tusk, T-U-S-K, skin, feathers, skull, S-K-U-L-L, skull, for which as a animals are hunt and their animal body parts are smuggled as illegally. But the obtained leather from the dead cows and buffaloes, this is not as a illegal, this is as the profession, this is as the one of the types of industries which are known as a pastoral based industries, which are obtaining the leather from animals. Leather used for a manufacturing of jackets, shoes, leather shoes, belts, wallets, so such kind of the material. But the killing of wild animals, this is as a illegal. So human predation is responsible for becoming the animals as endangered. Third reason responsible for the why do as animals are becomes as endangered as excessive use of pesticides and pollution. Excessive use of pesticides and pollution. The use of pesticides and pollution of the environment threaten excessive use of pesticides and pollution of environment threaten many bird and animal species. Many bird and animal species during the 1960s, scientific proof emerged that more than 20 bird species across Europe, North America were suffering with the disastrous breeding failures. Now you will raise as a why do we as we discussing here about the other nation, because in our country every year a large number of migratory birds, they are coming towards the Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary and Periyar. Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary and Periyar, P-E-R-I-Y-A-R. This is also the bird sanctuary. A large number of the migratory birds, like as a Siberian crane, during the winters, they are moving towards the Indian subcontinent. Due to as a excessive use of poisonous gases, the pollution which affected the breeding for which as a such migratory birds, they coming towards the Indian subcontinent. They were coming towards as a Indian subcontinent, their breeding structure, it was as affected due to as a pollution. Clear? So these are the reasons responsible for the animals becomes as endangered. Yes. So this much for today. Rest we will continue on tomorrow. Yes, Ashmit. If anybody having any questions?
Sir, 1930 mein kya proof kiya tha unhone?
Around the 1960s, the scientists they proved that they emerged that more than 20 bird species in Europe and North America, they were suffering with the disastrous breeding failures. They failed to breed.